Hey, welcome back to Music with Todd Ledbetter. Thank you so much for being here. My computer is making so much noise, so if you hear some kind of growling, it's my computer. Anyways, thanks for being here. I appreciate it. And we're back with some David Sylvian. So super excited about that. We're going to check out a song called When Poets Dream of Angels. And this is from his 1987 solo release, Secrets of the Beehive. And this is... Well, let's see. I'm looking at a remastered. I don't know if this one's remastered. I can't really tell much. So I'm not sure if what you're going to hear is the remastered version or not. So it could be 1987 original. I'm not sure. Oh, let me check real quick. Maybe I can find out. Yeah, it looks like just the original. I kind of want to hear the remastered, though. I wonder if I can find it. David Sylvian. Let's see. No, I'm not seeing a version of that here on the old YouTubers. Okay, well, back with what I started with. It's only 4 minutes and 8 seconds. It's not very long. Sounds good.
Thank you.
Very cool. Wow, that's probably the best thing I've heard from him. I mean, my favorite, I should say. That was really awesome. I love that. Those guitars, those two guitars sounded awesome together. And in the beginning, I was really enjoying the song right away, but and my brain just doesn't think melodies and voice in that low of a tone. And it's, I forget. Yeah, he's got a low register, you know. He's just, and that was just beautiful. What his rendition of that vocally was so nice. It fits so well with the song. And then when all of the rhythms and everything came in, that was pretty groovy. And that whole instrumental, so much sound effects. And those two guitars, those two acoustic guitars were so bright and so clean and so clear. Yet, man, I think there might have been more than two. I mean, there was one going, you know, just scraping the strings the whole time, kind of keeping a rhythm, you know, Elvis Presley style. But and then two other guitars just floating in and out. Man, just so cool. That was really neat. Now, does he play guitar? Is he one of those guitar players? Or is I think he's a keyboard player, too. I know that. Maybe not. No, I don't know if he is or not. Does he play? No, I don't know that. Does he play guitar? Was one of those guitar players him? I'd be impressed. But anyways, great song. I really enjoyed that. That was probably my favorite thing I've heard from him in his solo work. Really, really cool. Yeah. All right, well, let me know if there's anything else you'd like to hear. That was a great recommendation. Totally dug it. Fantastic. Thank you again for reminding me of his excellent, excellent musical abilities. Always fun to get back and to learn and get deeper into an artist. And Japan was his band that he sang in before he went solo. And that was the very first reaction video I did was a Japan video. So you can go back. Go back a year and you can find it, or just look up Japan in the search engine, and there's a couple of Japan songs in there. But yeah, his solo stuff sounds so clean, so cool. Very, very, very good. All right, well, thank you so much. I appreciate it. Make sure you guys subscribe to the channel. Almost at 10,000. You can help me do it this week. Come on now, by the end of the month. And then also like this video as well, so the YouTube algorithm will grab it and chew it up and spit it out to a bunch of other people. And let's see, what else? Ko-Fi, if you want to recommend a song over on Ko-Fi and help the channel, you can do that, or meet me over on Patreon. That'd be great. But until then, until next time, see you in the comments, see you in the next video, and all that good stuff. And we'll see you later. Bye-bye.